then they're not the same thing. As a matter of fact, be aware of people who have degrees. They got the wrong beyond. They got the beyond of the knowledge of a good and evil servant. As a man is not meant. I know we're living in an age of technology and all the rest of it, and I know all this, and we have to read and write, and I know, but there's something about intellectualism. There's something about forcing kids to absorb knowledge. See? There's something about culture. You know, making something of yourself. It seems like to be very serpentine. To be involved with paper and ink and words and dead things. As if that would make something of... And I know that some of us feel the deadness of that. We just can't go to school and suddenly, for some reason, we start... The door closes, something won't let us learn. Something won't... And we think we're stupid and we try hard and it gets drier. See, who understands me? You see? Now, I understand, thank God, every aspect of this horrible, grotesque thing. But as I speak to you, as I talk to you, I'm trying to shine the light on what it is that's wrong. For example, I just spoke about education. I'm not saying that you shouldn't be educated, but you have to be educated. Educare means the Latin for the real word for education means to bring forth from within, not to slap on like a coat of paint and make little robots, because when knowledge introduced that way also introduces the spirit of that knowledge, and that's another form of corruption. That's why education today, a valueless education that it is, for which reason we have the marine problem in Moscow. See, they trade their whole future for a mess of pottage, right? For a few sexual favor, they betrayed their country for a few bucks. And what kind of spirit is that, right? What kind of noble beings? But we're conditioning our children, see? In the guise of education, we're violating them and corrupting them and putting into that child a wrong spirit, a treacherous spirit, a spirit treacherous to all that is democratic and sweetly, democratically republican, you know what I mean? Constitutional, Bible. See, a treacherous spirit. And there are treacherous teachers out there that have ruined the minds of our young people and introduced to them, after they set the grounds for excellence, which is the exact opposite of excellence, decadence. Because the smarter you become, the lower you fall. You'll find that homosexuals are very bright people, very intellectually bright, glib, smart, just like serpents that they are. But the reason is that because the more intellect, the more you open your heart, your mind, and a spirit of pride enters and starts to gobble up. If you overcome that resistance, if you overcome the dryness of education, if you don't hear the warning of that threshold, see, and don't sense or don't acknowledge the warnings of danger not to cross that, it's dry over there, it's dead over there, don't go across. Better not learn. If you ignore that, you enter that world and the world enters you. It's a temptation. It's exactly the same as the knowledge of good and evil, except it's forced on us. See? Because we come into the world subject to those principles and principalities. It's one-upsmanship. It's what is waiting for us when we come into the world. See? And you're going to be a bum or a garbage collector if you don't study and become something. And they tease you and pressure you to learn, to study anything. It doesn't make a difference, poetry, literature, arts, even the right things, you know, before it's time. Pressure, 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 pressure. React, react, you've got to react. All of a sudden, now the kids have to listen to music in order to learn because they need the reaction to something. They need temptation to open their mind, to program their brain to remember anything at all. Haven't you noticed when you're excited, your brain is intellectually stimulated? Even if you're sick, your brain is intellectually stimulated. Your brain is very active. It becomes very, very foxy. You're angry, and your brain and intellect evolves. Excited, your brain's alive. If you get very sexual, you get into sex, all of a sudden you feel more intelligent. Who knows what I'm talking about? About sex, you feel, my, you could write home to mother afterwards, and you could write... great poetry after a good sex binge, right? Who knows what I'm talking about, right? See, there's something wrong with that. Something wrong with all these things, and I'm just verifying the fact that it's okay not to be involved in the educational scene. It doesn't mean to say you won't get educated. See? You may not be educated, but you'll become edukerated. I'm an edukerated person. I'm not an educated person. I haven't got a degree. I don't want a degree. I know more about psychology than they've ever... I've forgotten more than they'll ever learn. Where do I get my knowledge from? You see, because I'm evolving from my revelations. And therefore, that the part of me, that the evolution of realization, what the Bible calls the word make flesh, or, you know, living by faith. You know, the faith is dead, you have to have work. So when you realize something, you do it. You act out what you realize. See? And so it flows through you, just like education. You're stimulated by two forces when you come into the world, good and evil. And each one of them is equally stimulating. See? And therefore, when you've lost the inner stimulation, the edukerated, I've just made that the word, say, as opposed to educated, because educated are educated dummies. They're dead people, they won't lie down. And of course, they look like they know more than you, and maybe they do know more than you, but they don't know it in the right way. And they lord it over you. And they tempt you to follow them, like with a carrot at the end of a stick, you see. They make you doubt. They make you reach for that. And you start to enter their world and leave your own world behind. And their spirit, you go into their world, the spirit of the world enters you. And now, once you've separated from the world of your own understanding, then everything you might have been, it's gone. See, I say you could be everything you could be if you were just left alone and someone would protect you from all the educators and all the religious people and all the seducers. If the father could protect you from his mother, from your mother, because your mother is the pusher. Isn't she? She's the pusher. She's the source of men's motivation towards forbidden dreams and becoming something. Men who are not really men need such a woman to light a fire under them and to be their backbone. As I always say, behind every great man there's a great woman. But I always say, what's behind her? Right. Right. See? Yes.
Well, I have a question about being non-emotional.